السلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهديه واستنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين، وبعد. إن شاء الله بإذن الله today especially this coming night we expect is not 100%, but we expect based on many يعني talk by the Sahaba and the Tabi'een and also supported by some ahadith. We hope inshallah this coming night inshallah we'll do our best. Maybe that's the night of power. So the manzila we'll talk about today, the step يعني for those people going to Allah تبارك وتعالى of today, منزلة العفو والصفح. منزلة العفو والصفح. Everyone knows that is the best dua in the night of power, especially in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. The best dua, اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا، اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا، اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. إن شاء الله in few minutes إن شاء الله of today إن شاء الله we'll talk about العفو and الصفح. إن شاء الله العفو. العفو what's the difference between العفو and الصفح؟ Because Allah تبارك وتعالى said took the Quran about عفو and الصفح. فاعف عنهم and واصفح الصفح الجميل. So قال العلماء العفو التجاوز وترك الانتقام. العفو it means forgive and don't punish. That's the meaning of عفو. And الصفح ترك التأنيب والعتاب. الصفح it means even do not blame anyone. So when Allah says فاصفح الصفح الجميل it means there is no عتاب, no blaming after it. Whatever happened خلاص. So كما قال البيضاوي يقول العفو ترك عقوبة المذنب. ترك عقوبة المذنب. If Allah تبارك وتعالى gave us عفو it means Allah will never punish us. الصفح ترك لومه. ترك لومه. There is no room to blame him, inshallah. مكانة العفو والصفح في الإسلام مكانة عظيمة لا يصل إليها إلا من جرد نفسه لله وجاهد نفسه وكظم غيظه. No one will reach to this level of عفو of صفح until he his intention pure and also his goal to please Allah, not to please anyone else. So Allah تبارك وتعالى, just some references from the Quran. Allah told his Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم خذ العفو وأمر بالعرف يعني بالمعروف يعني وأعرض عن الجاهل. خذ العفو وأمر بالعرف. خذ العفو وأمر بالعرف وأعرض عن الجاهلين. خذ العفو خلقا لك. Take this خلق that's yours. خذ العفو. Accept this نعمة to forgive people. خذ العفو وأمر بالعرف وأمر بالمعروف وأعرض عن الجاهلين. You will face in your life many ignorant. So please don't waste your life with the ignorant. And the best way to stay away from many problem to stay away from that by عفو. And Allah تبارك وتعالى says also فاعفوا واصفحوا حتى يأتي الله بأمره. فاعفوا واصفحوا. Allah is talking to us. فاعفوا O believers. فاعفوا. Forgive. And also don't blame until Allah تبارك وتعالى is the one who will take care إن شاء الله. Allah تبارك وتعالى told his Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم also فاعفوا عنهم واصفح. إن الله فاعف عنهم واصفح إن الله يحب المحسنين. And Allah تبارك وتعالى also in the incident of al-ifk when the people Some people, they talk badly about Aisha radiallahu anha. They attack the honor of Aisha. Then Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu arda, he decided to cut the help, the aid to one of his relatives, Mustah ibn Athatha. He decided, خلاص, Mustah involved in attacking his daughter Aisha, the wife of Prophet Muhammad sallam. Abu Bakr, he used to help him before. Then he decided to cut this aid. And he said, خلاص, done. يعني, he got upset, which is normal. But Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says, told him in Surah An-Nur, وَلَا يَأْتَلِ أُولُو الْفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ وَالسَّعَةِ أَنْ يُؤْتُوا أُولِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْمُهَاجِرِينَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. Then Abu Bakr said, والله, I love the forgiveness of Allah. I love Allah to forgive me, so I forgave Mustah. And I am not going even to blame him, by single word. Imagine Abu Bakr, he came back. So Al-Afu also Amr al-Nabawi. Prophet Muhammad sallam, many verses in the Quran, just I gave samples. But Al-Afu Amr al-Nabawi. Prophet Muhammad sallam also, he guided us to do Afu. And I need you to focus this hadith with me, narrated by An-Nasai and Al-Hakim and Al-Darqutni wal-Bihaqi, by Abdullah ibn Amr radiyallahu anhu, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, تعافوا الحدود فيما بينكم فما بلغني من حد فقد وجب. It means الحدود. If the Prophet وسلم, as ruler, as hakim, as responsible about applying the rules of Allah, if the had reached him, he will apply. If any punishment approved, he has to apply. So, but what about if the people, they forgive each other before coming to the Prophet Muhammad, which is good. Forgive each other away from me. But if reaching me, I have to apply. But before reaching me, you have room to forgive each other. تَعَافُ الْحُدُودَ فِي مَا بَيْنَكُمْ. Forgive each other. Because if you came to me with all evidences that the sin committed, and this sin has punishment, specific punishment in the Quran or Sunnah, then I have to apply. So, but if you forgive us away from me, that's good. And also the other hadith narrated by Imam Ahmad radiallahu anhu and Uqba ibn Amr, that Prophet Muhammad sallam told him, Ya Uqba ibn Amr, Prophet sallam, he gave him specific advice for Uqba ibn Amr. Ya Uqba, O Uqba ibn Amr, صِلْ مَنْ قَطَعَتْ وَأَعْطِ مَنْ حَرَمَكْ وَعْفُ عَمَّنْ ظَلَمَكْ. He gave him three advice. صِلْ مَنْ قَطَعَكْ. صِلْ مَنْ قَطَعَكْ. Be kind with even people they are not kind with you. Be kind with them. صِلْ مَنْ قَطَعَكْ وَأَعْطِ مَنْ حَرَمَكْ. Give even someone, he never give you, but even he cut your right. صِلْ مَنْ قَطَعَكْ. مَنْ قَطَعَكْ وَأَعْطِ مَنْ حَرَمَكْ. والله صعبة. It is not easy. It is not easy. Usually, we visit and the kind with the people, they are kind with us. But to be kind with someone, he's very tough with you, that's a high level. That's al-afu. So, and the third one, and also to give someone, usually, we exchange the gifts and so between us. If someone gave me, I have to give him. But did you try to give someone he never gave you, and to continue giving him for the sake of Allah? That's a good khuluq. And the last one, the third one, Uqba ibn Amr, wa'afu amman zalamak. Forgive even if someone oppress you. Oppress you, it means take some money, take some right, and so something from the dunya, forgive him. Forgive him to be qualified for the forgiveness of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. A man also, his name Abu al-Ahwas, he came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as al-Tirmidhi narrated this hadith, قال يا رسول الله الرجل أمر به فلا يقريني ولا يضيفني. Some people, subhanAllah, they are stingy. I pass by him, even he doesn't say come for a cup of tea or so, لا يقريني or food or invite me for food or so. لا يقريني لا يطعمني. احنا مر به ليس هناك إكرام. It's not generous. Then بقول فيمر بي. Then one day he will pass by me also. He will pass by my house. So أفأجزي من أجزي. It means I have to be stingy also as he stingy. Then Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said no. No. قال لا أقره أي أكرمه وأحسن ضيافته ولا تقابله بمثل فعله. قال لا أقره. أقره يعني من القرى, من الكرم والجود والإطعام. So, ولذلك العفو, العفو من صفات الله. العفو من صفات الله. One of the names of Allah, العفو. العفو. One the attributes, one the صفات of Allah تبارك وتعالى, and the names of Allah, العفو. Allah تبارك وتعالى says, إن الله كان عفوا غفورا. وهو الذي يقبل التوبة عن عباده ويعفو عن السيئات ويعلم ما تفعلون. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم he mentioned the hadith, very famous hadith, everyone memorizes this hadith, that Aisha رضي الله عنها, she asked Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, if it is the night of power, what is the best dua? What is the best dua to ask Allah in this night? قال قولي اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عني. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عني. الله تبارك وتعالى هو العفو, له العفو الشامل. الله تبارك وتعالى وسع عفوه الورى, وسع ما يصدر عن عباده من الذنوب. وسع عفو الله ما يصدر عن جميع العباد من الذنوب, لا سيما إذا أتوا ما يوجب العفو عنهم من الاستغفار والتوبة والإيمان والأعمال الصالحة. من كمال عفوه سبحانه, من كمال عفوه الله تبارك وتعالى إذ العفو والفورغيفنس, من كمال عفوه سبحانه ما قاله الله عن نفسه ونادى عباده المذنبين العصاة. ناداهم في القرآن في سورة الزمر, في آخر أرباع سورة الزمر, يقول الله تبارك وتعالى قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله, لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله, إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا, إنه هو الغفور الرحيم, إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. وفي الحديث عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه, رضي الله عنه قال يا ابن آدم, الله تبارك وتعالى says in the hadith قدسي narrated by أنس رضي الله عنه that Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says, Allah says in the hadith قدسي, قال يا ابن آدم, oh the son of Adam, يا ابن آدم إنك ما دعوتني ورجوتني غفرت لك على ما كان منك ولا أبالي. Oh the son of Adam, if you came back to me and you ask with sincerity, with pure heart, coming back to repent to me, I'll forgive all what happened before. غفرت لك على ما كان منك ولا أبالي. يا ابن آدم, oh the son of Adam, لو أتيتني بقراب الأرض خطايا. If you came with sins, fill whatever between the heaven and the earth. لو أتيتني بقراب الأرض خطايا ثم لقيتني, then you met with me with no shirk, ثم لقيتني لا تشرك بي شيئا أتيتك بقرابها مغفرة. I'll come with you with similar or bigger بقرابها مغفرة. So and Allah تبارك وتعالى mentioned that if Allah تبارك وتعالى is not عفو, and if Allah تبارك وتعالى punished everyone based on his sin, والله الله will finish all the creation, all the creation, not even the human being, all creation. الله تبارك وتعالى says in the end of سورة النحل, ولو in سورة النحل, ولو يؤاخذ الله الناس بظلمهم ما ترك عليها من دابة. If Allah punish the people based on their sins, no single creation will stay. ما ترك عليها من دابة ولكن يؤخرهم إلى أجل مسمى. أن الله تبارك وتعالى لم يزل ولا يزال ينعم على جميع خلقه ويعفو عن المذنبين والمجرمين مع قدرته على عقابهم. أيضا الله always forgive, but Allah needs the person to come to him to be qualified for this afu. Come to Allah. Yes, admit I am sinner. Oh Allah, I want to be forgiven by you. Oh Allah, I admit that I committed sin, and they come and try to fix. That's in manzilat al-tawbah. We can talk about that. And also al-afu, khuluq min akhlaq al-anbiya. That's the behavior of the prophets. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala mentioned examples in the Quran, like Yusuf alayhi salam, even with what he faced. Allah, yesterday I received a call from brother, long call about dispute, problem between him and his brothers and so, regarding his father, that his father يعني, gave one of his sons some gift, and the other, they are very upset. Why he gave our brother that? Why done? And subhanAllah, imagine. And he did not even prevent them, and they admitted that he helped all of them to buy houses, to do that. But subhanAllah, when we come to Yusuf alayhi salam to find what happened from his brothers, they put him in the well, and still remember. And he, after that, he sold. He's a prophet. He sold as a slave. Then after that, he stayed to serve in the palace of Al-Aziz. Then they put him in the jail for 7 years. Then later on, after long story, Surah Yusuf, then they met with him. Then lately, when they discovered that's Yusuf, قالوا أَإِنَّكَ لَأَنْتَ يُوسُف. Allah subhanAllah, we never expect. We are come now after 40 years, we are in need from the one we put him in the well. أَإِنَّكَ لَأَنْتَ يُوسُف. قال أنا يوسف وهذا أخي قد من الله علينا إنه من يتق ويصبر فإن الله لا يضيع أجر المحسنين. Then they evaluate the dunya, not evaluate the deen. قالوا تالله لقد آثرك الله علينا. الله ما شاء الله, you are now better than us. وإن كنا لخاطئين. Then he said خلاص, let's forget what happened, flip the page, خلاص, we are not going to blame you. قال لا تثريب عليكم اليوم. لا تثريب, I am not going even to blame you. Forget what happened. Forget this. What I faced for 40 years. No problem. Alhamdulillah. That's the hikmah of Allah. Alhamdulillah. لا تثريب عليكم اليوم يغفر الله لكم وهو أرحم الراحمين. And the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم also in the Fath Mecca, then the people in Mecca, they are standing after he prayed to Raka inside Al-Kaaba, and he came out by the door of Al-Kaaba, and he put his hands on Udadatay Al-Bab, Bab Al-Kaaba. Then he looked to the people, the heads of Mecca, those who they gave him hard time for 21 years now, 8 years after Hijrah, 13 years before Hijrah, they gave him hard time. Then he asked them, ما تظنون أني فاعل بكم؟ What's your expectation about me? They said, Wallahi, you are the best one. The best one have the best akhlaq. You are not like us. We are ignorant, but you are not. You are on the top. أخٌ كريم وابن أخٍ كريم. He said, no single word to blame you again. Even Prophet Muhammad Sallam, when Akrima رضي الله عنه, the son of Abi Jahl. The son of Abi Jahl, he came to Islam, and when Akrima was coming to the gathering with Prophet Muhammad sallam, Prophet Muhammad sallam, before his arrival, he told the Sahaba, Hada Akrima, this is Akrima, the son of Abi Jahl, the son of Fir'aun, هذه الأمة, Abu Jahl, the enemy, the most enemy of Islam and Muslimin. He said, that's Akrima, but Akrima accepted Islam. Okay. Don't blame him for what happened now. Even don't talk badly about his father. قال فلا تسبوا أباه. Don't curse his father. فإن سب الميت لا يصله ويؤذي الحي. When you curse his father already, Allah will take care of him. But if you curse his father in front of Ikrima, you are hurting Ikrima. أيها الإخوة الكرام والأحبة. العفو جاء عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه يعني كان عفوه مضرب المثل. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يعفو ويصفح ويسامح ولا يلوم. I want to conclude with العفو من صفات الصالحين. العفو من صفات الصالحين. That's one of the characters of the صالحين, to forgive. Don't blame. Don't keep in your mind what happened 30 years ago. Don't come to your wife and tell her what happened when you went there 25, 30 years ago to ask her father for marriage and her father gave you hard time. Don't continue saying your father, he gave me hard time. He asked me what I cannot afford. خلاص, done. You still remember that? Yes. And also, sorry to say that, but Prophet Muhammad said that in the hadith. Some ladies also, they kept in their memory, they do not update the software. So they kept in their memory bad stuff long time from her husband. If anything new happened, she would say, oh, 30 years ago you did so and so. 25 years ago, Allahu Akbar. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تقول فإن رأت شرا, if she saw something now is not good, قالت ما رأيت منك خيرا قط. I never see any خير from you. How? Just this few spot, few black spot in the life, make all the life black. No, we are human beings. You can do something wrong, we have to forgive. Me also, I can do something wrong, you have to forgive me. And the conclusion, especially in Ramadan, the main fruits of fasting is at-taqwa. At-taqwa. How we can attain taqwa? Sometimes we, by mistake, we expect taqwa by fasting, qiyam, reading Quran, we'll attain taqwa. But the main reason for taqwa, al-afu. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says, وَأَن تَعْفُ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَى وَأَن تَعْفُ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَى. Oh, the best way to have taqwa, forgive. Forgive people to be qualified for the forgiveness of Allah. And the last verse we'll stop with, inshaAllah. That's the verses in Surah Ali Imran. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave us description of al-muttaqeen. وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين. والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون. عدم العفو يقود إلى سوء الظن, وسوء الظن يقود إلى الغيبة, والغيبة تقود إلى الكذب, والكذب يهدي إلى النار. We ask Allah تبارك وتعالى to let all of us strengthen our brotherhood in Islam for the sake of Allah by forgiving each other. Yes, we are human beings. Every one of us committing sin, every one of us doing something wrong, but we have to forgive for the sake of Allah. But also for those who committed sin, the door open. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala invited al-mushrikeen, invited those who worshipped Isa, those who worshipped al-Uzair. Allah says, أَفَلَا يَتُوبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. If wallahi, when Allah talk about the misguided people, then Allah says, the door open, come, come to Allah, come to Al-Afu, أَفَلَا يَتُوبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم صل اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم آمين جزاكم الله خير.